week, Hall of Famer Arnold Skolin, the former manager of the then WWF champion Bob Backlund, will tell us why he threw the towel in.
WWF's new generation.
Indeed, and how do you feel about working with Jerry the King Lawler?
Yeah.
I never worked with a king before.
No, I wouldn't imagine you have.
Wait a minute, I just got this in, Vince.
What's that?
The king's royal robe has not been washed in 6 months. It must stink.
Oh, come on.
Thank you, Charlie.
Some news.
Thank you very much, Charlie Vin. Who'll be giving us more live event news later on in the broadcast. Right now, Reno Riggins. Shoot to the roof, coming off. Underneath the roundhouse from the backside, look at this, round and round it. Hey, how about that crossbody? One, two, no. Reno Riggins off the rope again. Down goes Shawn Michaels.
What's Reno trying to do here?
Reno over the top rope.
Yeah, you'll not get one up on Shawn Michaels.
However, Captain Louis Albano certainly has one up as of late on the tag team champions, Shawn Michaels and Diesel, because Captain Louis Albano's introduced a third head shrinker, Cione.
Talk about sinking to new depths. What kind of trickery is this, McMahon?
I don't know, but Captain Louis Albano, the maker of more tag team champions than anyone else in WWF history, just may have made a new championship team.
Well, I guess so when you got three against two.
Now, there's only going to be two against two, but you just don't know which
That's
two it's
right.
going to be.
You don't know how to prepare. You don't know which two it'll be.
Shawn Michaels with Reno Riggins back in the ring. And what's he going to do with him now? Perhaps we'll see an upset. You never can tell what's going to happen in the WWF. From behind now, Michaels ripped off. Michaels hanging on the rope.
Oh,
devastating maneuver. That was the same maneuver, by the way, that cost Diesel the Intercontinental Championship.
Hey, watch it, McMahon. You're always trying to stir up controversy, always trying to cause dissension between these two, and there is none.
And there's a tag. You don't often see that. Oh, boot to the midsection. Look at Diesel. Diesel going to work now on Gary Scott. Scott coming off the rope.
Oh,
forget about it. Running into the proverbial Mack truck.
Hey. Yeah. You're
needs a shave, huh?
No, that is... The girls love that.
Yeah, sure they do.
Speaking of girls, have you seen the latest edition of the WWF magazine? Because Shawn Michaels has his advice to the lovelorn column in there.
Oh, there's a little advice for Gary Scott. No! And the advice is never, ever get into the ring with a 7-foot, 300-pound diesel.
Hey, I heard Doink wrote him a letter, wanted to know if he could fix him up with a date. And you know what Sean told him?
What?
What girl is going to go out with a guy that wears more makeup than she does? Hey,
and an easy cover for Shawn Michaels. Diesel.
Here are your winners.
And Michaels, the tag team champions of the WWF. But for how long? Who knows? They may cough up the championship on the WWF Heart Attack Tour. Nonetheless, they remain united, yes.
Look, they're the same height. Shawn's as tall.
Hey, wait a minute.
He's as tall as
Michaels
Diesel.
Is standing on his opponent. And you suddenly realize it. Yeah, right, sure. Michaels and Diesel, tag team champions, as we take you back to the replay.
Take a look at this, McMahon. Wow, that's about a size 15 boot right in the kisser. And then...
Oh, goodness.
How far did he fall?
Unbelievable action from the tag team champions, Michaels and Diesel. However, scheduled up, ladies and gentlemen, momentarily as they look at their action, Charlie Benn, who just made Lewis in on that robe he was talking about.
Not him again.
And Charlie's right. That robe stinks. Hey.
Hello, New York, and welcome everybody to my first ever live event news. And yes, there's my name right there, Charlie Mann. Let's get right into the triple header, the WWF Heart Attack World Tour, coming right here to the Meadowlands Arena Thursday night, October the 27th, in Long Island at the Nassau Coliseum, Friday night, October 28th. And how about Madison Square Garden, Saturday night, October the 29th, just 1 week away from this Thursday, Friday, and 2 weeks from today. Now, in addition to the great WWF superstars you're going to see right here in the New York area, how about a chance to sit in the graveyard section decorated by this tombstone? This is where the Undertaker supernatural power powers are at their greatest, and you can register to win free tickets at PC Richard and Sons, and one lucky winner will be able to win seats to Tombstone Row. Those are front row seats, and I have a chair right now to show it to you. Yes, this is part of Tombstone Row. You can take this chair home with you if I can get it open at the end of the evening. And in addition, you can get picked up at home and brought to the arena by the Undertaker's personal funeral coach and coachman. Let's get right to the card. Yes, how about the Bob Backlund Challenge? Can anyone break out of the chicken wing? I'll try it on this chicken right now. No, you can't break out of it. Let's go right back to the matches. Duke the Dumpster Drozzi on one side, IRS on the other. Adam Bomb will try to put away Bam Bam Bigelow. The Smoking Guns and Tag Team Action will try to upend the Heavenly Bodies. Doink with Dink at his side against Jerry the King Lawler with a Prince at his side. Made in the USA, Lex Luger will try to get revenge on Tatanka. How about the championship match? Can the Anvil take the belt away from Bret Hart? And the tremendous casket match, The Undertaker with Paul Bearer against Yokozuna. Unbelievable matchup. The winner has to throw the loser in a casket and close the lid. Can you imagine being in that casket and seeing that lid just close on you? What a helpless feeling. You will not want to miss it right here in the New York area. Let's get lucky tickets. Yes, they will be available at the box office and at all Ticketmaster outlets. Once again, those dates, the 27th at the Meadowlands Arena, the 28th in Long Island, and the 29th in Manhattan.
Come, ladies and gentlemen, the man made in the USA, Lex Luger, will be in action, and for that matter, so will Yokozuna.
Oh, yeah, my man.
And we'll have a very special interview with Arnold Skolin, the man who used to manage the former WWF champion Bob Backlund. We'll get to the bottom of this throwing in the towel
issue. Will you really ask him the hard question of why he did that?
You've got it, King.
I want you to ask him right to his face.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Start your engines. Bob Holly, a double sport superstar, whether it's on the stock car circuit or in the squared circle right here in the WWF. Bob Holly looking good.
What do you mean saying something about my robe? Look at that coat you're wearing.
What's wrong with us?
I guess nothing. They made great suits back in 1970.
Wow, this is Bob Backlund. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll have action with Bob Spark Plug Holly when we return. We're back with more WWF action, and Mike Bell ready to lock up with Bob Spark Plug Holly. We mentioned earlier on about Bob Spark Plug Holly being a double sport superstar. He is headed, by the way, in December. Big race coming up down in Pensacola, Florida.
Yeah.
Bob Spark Plug Holly's going to be in the Snowball. Ooh, look at that. Snowball Derby.
Snowball Derby?
You got it, Ed. Mike Bell. Uh-oh. Mike Bell attempting to make a maneuver there on Bob Spark Plug Holly. He takes Bell over the hip.
Wait a minute. You mean he's going to be driving
nicely
in a race called the Snowball Derby in Pensacola, Florida in December?
You got it.
He's got about as much chance as a snowball in Florida winning, too. To get it? Snowball in Florida.
Well, you're a riot this week. You got queasy. You got snowballs. Oh, you're something.
I'm happy now.
And you also stink. That robe is rotten.
No, wait a minute.
The longer we stay out here under these television lights by the ringside area, the more that robe has a certain odor to it. Oh, look at this. Mike Bell hammering away on Spark Plug Holly. And to the buckle goes Bob Holly. Bell moving in now on Bob Holly. Holly certainly no stranger to living with danger. To the buckle again.
Oh, I'd like to challenge him to a race myself.
A race?
Yes.
You?
Yes.
You don't have the guts to drive a stock car.
I'm talking about running. I guarantee you I can outrun him any day of the week.
Well, you have been noted for running away from your opponent.
Hey.
That's not Bob's. Whoa! What a clothesline. That's not Bob Holly's style at all. Matter of fact, Holly knows one way, and that's pedal to the metal, whether it's on the racetrack or in the squared circle. And right now, Mike Bell is... Ooh, he'll feel the effect of that knee.
No, I certainly do not drive like that. I observe all traffic laws and use my right and turn, left turn indicator and all proper driving procedures.
I'm sure you do.
I bet Bob Holly doesn't do that.
And dropping the elbow is Bob Holly. By the way, following this matchup, ladies and gentlemen, a special interview with the Hall of Famer. We promised you we're going to get to the bottom of the story as it relates to Arnold Skolan. Oh! And a body slam there by Holly.
Yeah, I want you to promise me this, McMahon. I want you to ask him the hard question. Have you got the guts to ask him that?
No,
why
problem.
He threw in the towel? Oh, you will?
Wait and see. All right, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, from the top rope.
Whoa!
Wow, what a maneuver, a cover, a count, a victory. That's the checkered flag. Goes up for Bob Spark Holly. And I'm going to have to get out of here and prepare for the interview.
You're
all right, King, it's all yours. Go ahead.
Oh, terrific. get out of here. You know, well, now that I think about it, this show's not the same without McMahon. It's better. Hey, you'll be back with more of the King after this.
Your father. Last night, I hurt someone real bad.
Elaborate, my son. What provoked this act?
I wanted his belt, man.
But, my son, it is written, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's goods.
Hey, man, he took the first swipe.
Haven't we always been told to turn the other cheek?
Yes, father. But when he took that swing at me, he broke my toothpick. So I raised him high above my head and slammed him to the ground.
Toothpick? You slammed a man to the ground because he knocked a toothpick from your mouth? Who do you think you are, Razor Ramon?
Why, father, how'd you know?
The new WWF generation. Put your faith in us.
And this one's for Father Carrick. And this one's for Sister Joyce.